Let's give a big hand to Cardale Jones. Cardale Jones. Started from the bottom, that's what we're here. We're here for Cardale Jones. Let's give him a big hand. Let me thank you for coming and sharing this moment in time. This is the village that helped raise Cardale Jones. We want to thank all of you for coming out and making this a festive event. Cardale will be making an announcement in a few minutes. I'll be remiss if I did not personally thank individuals who have made this successful in this community. One, the mayor of the city, Mayor Frank Jackson. Also, my CEO with us today, Mr. Eric Gordon. Also with us is Mr. Patrick Zahn, Chief Operating Officer. And certainly three gentlemen who are very powerful and prominent in this community, Councilman Jeffrey Johnson, Councilman Mike Palencia, Kevin Conwell. Also, Anthony Harrison, who is with us today from the county. I'd like to thank you, Mr. Harrison, for being with us. We thank all of our parents, our students, our coaches, and especially the man who molded and made Cardale what he is, and that is Coach Ted Ginn Sr. Let's give him a big hand. Again, to thank you for sharing this moment with us, we have with us with Cardale is Florence Jones, William Jones, Devontae Jones, Michelle Nash, and Cena Jones. We thank you for being here with us and to share this moment. At the end, we will have any announcements that anyone want to make from the press. You could do it at the end. But this time, I want to bring to the podium the man of the hour, the man of the moment, the man who won the Sugar Bowl, the man who took us to the Super Bowl of football, and who has been a proud product of this Cleveland Isle community. This is the village. Let's all of us stand and recognize and welcome to the podium, Mr. Cardale Jones.
First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out, showing their support, you know, as they've been doing for me for my whole entire career. You know, my decision was very simple. You know, after talking over to my family, my friends, my coaching staff, I'm gonna return next year for school. You know, I mean, it's everybody's dream and goal, you know, when they play football or any collegiate sport to make it to the next level, but. And my point in my career, I feel like, you know, it's the best for me to go back to school, and one of the most important things for me to do is to graduate. So when I make that decision, you know, to play in the NFL, I want to be done with school. You know, I want to devote all my time and all my effort into the film room and getting better at playing the quarterback position. So thank all you guys for coming out. I mean, I don't know why you guys made it such a big deal, but I mean, like I said, it was very simple for me, man. The NFL after three games was really out of the question for me. So thank you guys again, and you can open up for questions.
Any questions? Cardale, when did you make the decision, and was there any doubt in your mind? Did you waver at all?
I mean, yeah, it was a little doubt because, like I said, that when the opportunity presented itself to me, I mean, of course, you know, I want to play in the NFL, but I want the time to be right.
When did you make the decision?
I mean, it was always made, but, I mean, I wanted to talk it over with Coach Meyer and my family and Coach Ginn.
Cardale, can you talk about the conversation with Urban Meyer? Were any assurances made that you will be the starting quarterback?
No, I mean, not at all. You know, I want to go back to school and compete for the spot. I don't want anything given to me.
Cardale, how do you view quarterback competition next year?
Unbelievable. You know, we have three guys that's able to play anywhere in the country.
And if, obviously, two of you guys are not going to be the starter, how will you two, whichever two it is, how will you handle that?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, I have to deal with that when that time comes. Hopefully, I am the starter. But, I mean, if I'm not, I have to wait till my opportunity to present itself again.
Cardale, pro day, and then a combine, and when people get a look at you and the skills that you have, the momentum that's there, you could have possibly been, and it may sound crazy to some people, a first-round draft pick. Did you? I'm sure you thought it all through, but that could actually have happened for you.
I mean, yeah, I thought it all through, But, I mean, them chances are slim. And like I said before, the most important thing for me, I mean, football always been, a stepping stone for my education. So being a first-round draft pick means nothing to me without my education. Anything else?
Any more questions? Questions?
Can you talk about who you sought counsel from on this decision? Who was your close circle that advised you on this?
I mean, I have a pretty close inner circle, and I like to keep that private because, I mean, that's what's the most unique thing about my circle. You know, it's small and it's private, and it's people that I trust, and it's people that I know that have my best interests at heart.
What do you say to folks who say you're making a mistake?
I mean, I can't say what I want to say to them who's thinking that, but, I mean, it's my life. I have to live it, not them.
Cardale, Coach Meyer was here this morning. You guys had a meeting with Coach Ginn in the office. Did you tell Coach Meyer of your decision? Does he know you're staying?
Yeah, he know. And he gave me his opinion on if I stay or leave. You know, he was always about, you know, taking an opportunity when the opportunity presents itself, but making sure that the opportunity come at the right time, not after three games.
Okay, what was his reaction when you told him?
He was shocked. He was a little shocked, but he understood, you know. He always practiced. He always preached to us, you know, that our education is most important. And he know and we know that, you know, with all three of us back next year, it's going to bring out the best in us.
Cardale, do you think can you guys find a way to play three guys at quarterback?
I mean, I doubt it, but you never know with Coach Meyer.
Did you talk to Braxton and JT much about this as you were going through the decision?
I mean, not really. You know, them guys have things going on in their life, in their personal life, especially Braxton, you know, with his decisions that he had to make. And they just really trying to get better and recover from their injuries. So, I mean, it's been, just like I said, a personal and a family decision.
Was there ever a point when you thought maybe you were going to go?
I mean, yeah, you get all the hype in the beginning, you know, but you really have to think it out. You know, it's cool to say that you was in a conversation with the first and second round draft pick after three games. But, I mean, you really got to think about your long-term jeopardy, not just, you know, jumping to the NFL and getting a lot of money.
How much have you shown of what you can be as a quarterback, or how much better do you think you can be as a quarterback next year?
In my opinion, I think I can get a lot better. You know, as each week and each game went on, I got a lot better and I progressed. So with a full offseason, you know, taking the reps as a one, you know, it will help me, you know, be the best quarterback I can possibly be.
Still be living, Titus.
Yeah.
You called this a life-changing decision today on Twitter, so how is this going to change your life?
I mean, yeah, because the way that I'm going to get viewed now and the way that, you know, I'm going to go about my business now, it's completely different.
Cardale, how much did it affect the decision, if at all, that you had such a tight deadline, you only had until today to decide?
I mean, that was another thing I had to deal with, you know, just won the national championship a couple of days ago, then you got 2 or 3 days to make a decision that's going to affect not you, but your whole family. And it was tough, you know, it's a process, it's a long process, that 2 or 3 days is not enough time.
How much feedback did you get from NFL people or from Ohio State coaches on what your draft stock would have looked like had you come out?
I mean, a lot, you know, a lot. Definitely from Coach Ginn and Coach Meyer, from sources they trust and sources that's reliable. So, I mean, it was flattering to hear your name in a second round or late first round in draft picks. But, I mean, like I said before, you got to think about the long-term jeopardy.
Cardale, is this feedback you were getting? Was this just after the championship game, or were you getting recruited as well?
A little after the Alabama game, but more so after the championship game.
For you, you got a young family. Did that factor into your decision at all, knowing that you had a possibly golden ticket, so to speak, to help make it to the NFL?
Yeah, definitely. But my education is going to take me 10 times further than my athletic ability.
Did you consider asking the NFL or have Ohio State ask for an extension about making this decision?
No, not really. You know, like I said before, what really boiled down to is going back to school and getting it out the way before I can make that full-time commitment to be a professional athlete.
Cardale, did Coach Meyer in his meeting at all, you guys talked about next year, is it an open competition at quarterback? Are you happy to go back into that role? Because
about
the possibilities of three of you having an open competition, or what was that talk about?
I mean, it wasn't talked about so much. You know, he still have to deal with recruiting, and we still, I mean, the season literally just ended 3 or 4 days ago. You know, he's not making, he didn't make me any promises. You know, he told me what I have to do and what I have to improve on, and that was about it.
Mr. Jones, as an educator here at Ginn Academy, the best school in Cleveland, under Ted Ginn and Nick Petty, I'm really proud of you for following the path of education. Without an education, you can't be. So what are your educational goals? What will you be studying?
I actually want to major, I want to study, after the life after football, I want to be a financial planner. So, I mean, like I said before, my football and my career window is so short. But, I mean, after I'm done with football, I still have my whole life to live. So, and that's what I think my education will come in handy.
Have you had a chance to, I know the last 24 hours have been kind of crazy, but have you had a chance to, you've been all over all the national sports networks and you've had NFL draft experts talking about where you should go or if you should go and why you should or shouldn't go. Have you had a chance to hear anybody? Because you've been all over the place for the last 24 hours. You have put Cleveland, especially the city of Cleveland, on the map.
Yeah, not really. You know, I didn't never feed into the hype, you know. Definitely when, you know, we have so much hype around us this season as far as, you know, losing two Heisman Trophy candidate quarterbacks. But so the hype is never, I never let it get to me.
One more question.
It is said of show business that you have your own tough act to follow now. You won a national title. It just doesn't get any bigger than that. Are you worried about living up to those expectations? And is it your expectation that Ohio State can theoretically put itself in position to challenge again next year for that national title?
Yeah, I mean, right now I'm not worried about too many of the expectations. Like I said before, the season really just ended, you know. Guys are still trying to recover from injuries and the rest and to get their academic semester started. So the expectations, we'll deal with them in the off season when they come. But like I said before, I mean, it's nothing for us to go out and do what we just did again.
Be back in class tomorrow?
Huh?
Back in class tomorrow?
Tuesday.
Okay, thank you very much. Appreciate it. I have to look forward to my friend. My granddaughter. There you go. Huh? Oh, yeah, no question, baby. Thanks again. Appreciate you, okay? Always good to see you, man. All right, man.